Hello, everybody. Thanks for joining me for this IELTS Academic Writing Preparation Lesson. Today, we're going to focus on the IELTS Task 2 essay. Specifically, we'll be looking at a cause and effect essay. Now, in this lesson, I'm going to give you an overview of scoring when it comes to the Writing Task 2. We'll look at an example question together, work on an outline, and then together we will write an essay. And as we do that, I'll show you some great tips and tricks, as well as things to avoid and things to definitely include. So without further ado, let's get started. Now, before we get into our outline and our question for this video, I just want to remind you a bit of the scoring. Now, this is something you'll have to keep in mind when you're writing your essays during test day, and it's also important to keep it in mind today so that it's fresh in your memory, and I'll be referencing these various points in scoring as we go along the video. So just to refresh your memory, the IELTS examiners will be looking for four things when they are grading the Writing Task 2 essay. The first thing is task achievement. This basically involves the question, did you fully answer the question that was given to you, and did you present it in a fully developed answer? So we want to avoid things that are half written or half argued. We really want to make sure everything is fully developed. The second part will be coherence and cohesion. This is easy to remember because we need to make sure that our writing makes sense and that it is well thought out and planned, again, in a very complete way. So you see these two things go together. The third point is the lexical resource, and this is something that students find a bit difficult. And this requires a lot of outside knowledge, a lot of vocabulary preparation. Basically, you want to make sure that your essay is virtually error-free when it comes to your word choice and your grammar, and you want to make sure that you're using a wide range of vocabulary in a very natural but also very formal tone, because remember, this is an exam and you want to use formal language. And the last point is grammatical range and accuracy. This is another point that students usually find a bit difficult because it's a bit strange, perhaps, to use a wide range of grammatical structures in one piece of writing. And this could include past perfect continuous, using passive voice. There are many things you have to keep in mind. And a lot of students struggle to fit various types of grammar and different structures into one essay. But if you really make it your plan and think about it, it should not be that difficult. I just want to note that the task achievement and coherence and cohesion, like I said, are linked. They usually go hand in hand, and we can say the same thing about the lexical resource and the grammatical range. A lot of this is based on your outside knowledge, your outside preparation in terms of grammar and vocabulary. So just keep this in mind, and let's go ahead and move on to what we're going to cover in this lesson today. So like I said earlier, the cause and effect essay is what we're going to be focusing on. Basically, the explanation for this question type is you're either going to be given a problem or a situation of some kind, and you'll have to describe its causes and its effects. So you want to be sure to give a well-rounded answer. And we're going to look at an example in just a minute. Before we do, I want to give you a guide of what to expect for this video. The first thing is that when you look at the question, we're going to read and understand what is the question and what is it asking you to do. Now, today it's very clear that the essay will be cause and effect, but on your test day and when you practice at home on your own time, you'll have to read and understand the question in order to realize what type of essay you have to write. So by doing that, we're going to make sure we really dissect the question itself and, of course, underline any key words. This is something that is present in various types of IELTS exams, different types of sections. Keywords are always important. Secondly, we're going to plan an outline. Now, a lot of students might think that planning an outline takes up time. I'll show you why that is not the case and why an outline is so important. So we're going to plan an outline together based on the cause and effect essay type. And as we plan the outline, we're also going to make outline notes. So this will help us prepare our actual writing for the test. And this will help us prepare the sentences and the words that we want to use. And number three is actually really important as a step because it helps with the lexical and grammatical components of the scoring. All right, so this is your guide. And now let's go ahead and look at the question. Now, here's the question we're going to focus on today. First, we're just going to read through it. And then the second time, I'm going to underline the keywords. And with more practice and becoming more familiar with this process, you can combine these two steps. So you can read and underline for keywords at the same time. All right, let's get started. So it says, even though governments have worked hard to bring about improvements in the healthcare system, the overall standard of physical health in developed countries is decreasing. What are the potential reasons for this? And what are some long-term effects? Okay, now let's read through it and underline the keywords. So even though we don't need to underline, it's a good connector, it's a good introduction, but it doesn't give us any information about the question itself. So we can skip even though. Even though governments is quite important, have worked hard to bring about improvements, a great keyword here, in the healthcare system. Now, this is important because it's specific about what the governments have brought improvements towards. So far we have governments, improvements, and healthcare system. The overall standard of physical health, this is important because we're not talking about mental health or anything else, we're talking about physical health in developed countries. So we're not talking about third world countries, but we're very specific with developed countries, is decreasing. And of course, you want to underline decreasing. What are the potential reasons for this? And what are some of the long-term effects? And this is very important, this last sentence, because it tells us exactly what type of essay we need to write. Usually in this exam, the last sentence of the writing prompt will give you an excellent clue as to which type of essay, one of the six, you need to write. And the fact that we see reasons and effects shows us that this is a cause and effect. Now, don't be surprised if you see reasons instead of causes. It's just another way to say cause. Okay, so now that we have our keywords, we're ready to really tackle this question. But before we get into our outline, I want you to ask yourself two questions, and I'll go ahead and write these questions. The first one you want to ask yourself is, what type of essay will I need to write? And as we talked about, this is going to be a cause and effect essay because you have your reasons and you have your effects. So that's the first thing you need to ask yourself. The second thing you want to ask yourself is, how familiar am I with this topic? The topic being governments and physical health and improvements in the healthcare system in general. Now, this depends on you. But keep in mind that the keywords here are going to help you assess your own knowledge. So, for example, if you are very familiar with healthcare in third world countries rather than developed countries, it's not really going to make much of a difference for this question because this question is very specific in that it's asking you about physical health in developed countries. And this question here, B, is quite important because you'll already know how much time you need to devote on making your outline, on brainstorming ideas, and coming up with a plan. So this is a great first step. Okay, we read the question, we underlined the keywords, and we thought briefly about these two questions, A and B. Now you might be thinking, wow, this is a lot for a first step. But trust me, like I said, with more practice, you can do all of this in about 1 minute or less, honestly, because you can read and underline at the same time. This question A should be very evident from the last question, and then you just have to think about your own personal knowledge. Okay, now our first step is finished. Now we're going to plan the outline and make outline notes. All right, now as we talked about earlier, our second and third steps are going to involve writing and making notes for the outline. Now, each type of essay has a different outline. And so the more you practice, the more you'll become familiar with the steps, you'll memorize the steps, and then when it comes to test day, you'll be very confident in organizing your essay in a very clear manner. This outline is extremely important for the coherence and cohesion point in the scoring, so do not skip it. First, you'll want to start with an introduction. Then you'll want to give two causes and two effects. We're going to separate them. So we see cause one and cause two, effect one and effect two, and then we're going to close with a conclusion. So it's quite simple. We've got four different points, two causes, two effects. Well, let's get started. Okay, now I've written out our outline that I just showed you. So the introduction, the causes, one and two, the effects, one and two, and the conclusion. I've added the actual sentences and descriptions of the sentences that you'll have to write. So this is something that you'll have to keep in mind and remember for the cause and effect question type. This outline is excellent because it's very well organized, which will get you points in the coherence and cohesion. And the fact that it's very organized allows you to realize that you are answering the whole question, and this will help you with the task achievement. So before we get started, I just want to show you what it would look like. And we have an introduction here. So you'll generally need about two sentences for this section. So I'll go ahead and write two sentences. The first sentence is basically a rewritten question. So you should basically just paraphrase the question here that was given to you. So you're rewriting the question in your own words using synonyms. And this will help you in a few ways. First, it guarantees that your essay is on target. So for the task achievement, you're getting points. And it's following the theme given to you. And it'll actually give you a chance to show the examiners that you have a really great vocabulary, because if you're using synonyms for these words, the examiner who reads your essay will know that you've got a wide range of vocabulary and you're able to rewrite certain things in your own voice, okay? And the second sentence here will introduce the specific topics that you plan to discuss here in your body. And this is why you'll have to spend some time thinking about what you want to write. Now, the causes and the effects, these two paragraphs, this is going to be the body, the meat of your essay. And in general, each paragraph should be about 4 to 5 sentences long. And you see here, we have broken them down for you. So the first sentence will always be a topic sentence that introduces the paragraph. And then you should have about 2 causes and 2 effects, okay? And you'll have an explanation or detail of the first cause with an example. Do the same thing for the second cause, and do the same thing for your effects. So this is quite standard, it's quite simple, but it keeps you on track and you know that you're answering the whole question. And lastly, you'll need a conclusion, all right? This should be around 3 to 4 sentences, okay? And the first sentence should be a summary of the main points. In this case, since we have 2 different paragraphs in the body, it should be about 2 sentences, more or less, okay? The last point should be about 1 to 2 sentences. And a standard rule here is just to say something important about the topic. Perhaps its relevance in society, or just a closing statement that sort of wraps everything up. And I'll show you exactly what that will look like in our case. Okay, so this is pretty standard here. The best way to do it is just to keep this in mind and then call upon your own knowledge to build your outline. So now that we have looked at the outline and we've developed it, our second step is completed, and we are now going to make our outline notes. So either write this down or keep a mental note of it, because I'm going to rewrite our notes right here. Now, like I said earlier, the outline will help you for task achievement and coherence and cohesion, Writing out your notes before you actually start writing your essay will help you with a lexical resource, and it will get you thinking about the grammar structures that you want to use when you actually write your essay. So this will help you with vocabulary and grammar. Now, the notes I'm going to be making is based off of the keywords in our question and also on my own outside knowledge. So I'm sort of just brainstorming about what I know about governments and the healthcare system. And I'm also thinking about what would be easiest for me to write, because remember, you have about 40 minutes to write this essay. So even if you're not an expert on the topic, really brainstorm and think of anything that you can write or what comes easiest to you. So again, just thinking about the keywords, I remembered that governments was a keyword. We were talking about the healthcare system, and we were talking also about physical health in the developed countries, okay? And again, we're looking at reasons and effects. So for my rewritten question, I'm just going to think about different ways I can reword this. And I would say health problems is a good way to talk about improvements in the healthcare system, and physical health is decreasing. Notice that problems isn't necessarily included in this question, but I'm going to add it as a synonym. It says here, the overall standard of physical health in developed countries is decreasing. I'm going to say that it's widespread in the developed world. So you see that world is not really used. You see developed countries. This is just another way to say the question in my own words. And then the introduction of specific topics is the fact that I am going to discuss the reasons why, okay, we could say the causes, and the long-term effects. So this just gives me a plan, and you can write this in your margins of the test booklet, and as you're actually writing out your essay, you can glance at this, okay? You can also make a little X once it's been completed, or you can strike through it when it's been completed, and this just keeps you on track. Okay, now for the causes, of course, my topic sentence is just going to introduce the paragraph, and we'll get to that later. But I'm going to think of my two causes here. And something that is just fresh in my mind is going to be unhealthy diet, because I know that when people don't eat healthy foods, this usually contributes to a lower standard of health. And as an example of unhealthy food, I'm going to talk about fast food, because this is also just something that I hear about every day. And for me, it would be easy to write about fast food contributing to an unhealthy diet, which would contribute to low physical health. And the second cause, I'm going to say stress. So a stressful lifestyle. And an example of this, I could say perhaps difficult work-life balance, or perhaps someone has no time to eat well. Okay. Now keep in mind that the words you are writing, these are just words to spark your memory and remind you of what you want to write when you're actually writing down your essay. You don't have to have perfect grammar. You don't have to have complete sentences in your outline, okay? Just in your actual essay. All right, let's go into our effects. So I've got my two causes, good. My two effects, I would say an effect of this unhealthy diet and low standard of health will be the fact that it can continue on to future generations. This is an effect. And I think of future generations. I think perhaps genetic problems can develop or continue. Okay, that is my example. Another effect could be a higher cost of living because people are spending more on medical bills and medical problems. And so an example of that could be expensive healthcare. All right, so I've thought about my two causes and my two effects. Now for the conclusion, I have a summary of the main points. Basically, I'm talking about how diet from here, okay, and stress, so my two causes, contributes to future generations and a higher cost of living, basically. This is my summary. I've combined my two causes and my two effects. And then the second point is something important about the topic. I'll talk about the importance it has on society and on society's future, perhaps. Okay. Okay. And this is my outline. So I've just completed steps 2 and 3. I've made the outline and I've also made my notes. Your notes might look a bit different. Your causes and your effects might also look a bit different based on your own knowledge or your own opinions or what is easiest for you to write. And that's fine. Just keep in mind that you should be quick as you can, as quick as possible, writing these notes. And like I said, don't focus on your grammar here, but this already gets you thinking about the grammar that you can use in your essay. So the fact here that I'm talking about the future, I know that I can use some future tenses here. Perhaps talking about stress and a difficult work-life balance, I can use some present perfect. Perhaps thinking about someone who has worked in a certain industry for a long time, I can talk about how stress has contributed to his or her life. And so present perfect can be used here. I've got future, perhaps future perfect or future continuous here. Also the conclusion, we'll talk a bit about the future. So this already has me thinking of what I can possibly add to get a great score in the grammar, usage, and range. Okay, now we're going to start writing our essay. Okay, now I have my outline on the left-hand side, so you can follow along with the outline here. And I'm going to write my essay on the right-hand side here. This is something that you can do during the test day. So if you write your outline in the margins, you can reference it and again, cross out things that you've done, and this will help you stay on track. So without further ado, I'm looking at the introduction. That's where I'm going to start. And I see my phrases and my words here. So I'm going to make a sentence that also talks about this question statement here. So I would say health problems, and I would give some examples. So including heart disease, obesity, and diabetes are becoming more widespread. This is my word here. And I'm going to talk about where in developed countries. Okay, this is my first sentence. Now I'm going to talk about the reasons why. So I'm going to write, there are several reasons, because I'm talking about two causes and two effects. So several reasons contributing to this problem, as well as potentially drastic long-term effects. Now, these are my two sentences. I've got my introduction, first introductory statement, and the reasons why. And this sentence here sets the stage for the causes and the effects. Now, notice how I was quite quick in this. Of course, I'm teaching you how to write this, so I've got ideas really at the ready. So do not be deterred if you see that I'm typing quickly or that ideas are coming quickly. It's just because I've made my outline and I'm quite familiar with the topic, but go at your own pace. Just keep in mind that you have 40 minutes for the whole thing. Okay, I'm going to go to my second paragraph. I'm going to start with my topic sentence, which introduces the paragraph. And I'm going to start by saying lifestyle choices are important and major causes of poor health in developed countries. Okay, that's my topic sentence. Because basically, unhealthy diets and stress are lifestyle choices. Okay, now I'm going to go into my second sentence, which would be my explanation. And I'll go ahead and put this in italics so that we know it's number two, it's the explanation. And I'll say, these days, okay, it is perhaps easier and cheaper to follow an unhealthy diet. So I've got my unhealthy diet. I say that it's easier and it's cheaper because I'm going into fast food. So for my example, I'm just going to do that in regular text. For example, which is a great transition, the recent boom in fast food restaurants and chains has enticed people to eat at these establishments. Okay, I don't want to repeat restaurants. I want to say something else. So I think of establishments rather than cooking healthy meals at home. And this is just an example. So the recent boom has enticed people. So this is how I'm adding in present perfect, because I know that recent is a great way to use present perfect, and I've already used present perfect. So if you hadn't planned ahead, you might have just used present simple and say a lot of people eat at fast food restaurants, and that wouldn't have done you any favors for the grammar range. All right, so already we have our topic sentence, our example here, and our explanation as the second sentence. Now it's time to go into stress, which is going to be our other explanation. So I'll put that in italics, and I'll say stress is another factor that has contributed to poor health. Okay, very simple, but it introduces stress. Now I'm going to give an example, and I'll say something like the fast-paced corporate culture, okay, and competitive work atmospheres make for a difficult work-life balance, which is something that I wrote here as well in my outline. And I'll say resulting in little to no time for eating healthy or taking care of oneself. All right, so there we go. There we have it, is our first full paragraph in our body. The topic sentence, explanation, example, explanation, and another example. In terms of grammar, I've used the present perfect. In terms of vocabulary, some good phrases, little to no time, taking care of oneself. It's quite formal. And remember, we're writing a formal essay. And so just keep note of that. All right, let's continue to our third paragraph here, and we're looking at the effects. So I've just described these choices, and for my topic sentence, I'm going to say these lifestyle choices will have drastic long-term effects. Remember, I wanted to focus on the future here. And now we're talking about continuing on to future generations. So I'll put this in italics. I'm going to say if generations continue to partake in these unhealthy habits, they will continue on for generations to come. And this is sort of my long-term effects. This is my idea. So I'm relating it back to the question. As an example of this, I'm going to say, for instance, because I've already used for example, so I don't repeat that. I'm going to say, for instance, parents who have diabetes, okay, I'm just thinking of an example of a problem, a health problem. So parents who have diabetes or are prone to obesity have a higher chance of passing these conditions on to their children, and so on. Now notice these are some great phrasal verbs. So passing something on, so passing on with conditions in the middle is great. So on is also a great phrase. Let's continue with our second explanation. So I'll go ahead and put that in italics. I'll use a transition word. So I'll say, consequently, these health problems could result in a higher cost of living. Okay, and I'll just put that all in italics so that we know it's our next point. And then as an example to close this off, I'll say, due to increased demand for services, it is only natural that the healthcare industry would charge higher prices to its clients, resulting in higher costs. So I've kind of explained why higher cost of living is due to expensive healthcare. And there is my second paragraph. Okay. Now to wrap everything up, I'm going to show that diet and stress lead to future generations having problems and a higher cost. And so I'm just going to wrap it up and say poor lifestyle choices, and I'll give an example, ranging from unhealthy diets and higher stress, have certainly contributed to the decrease in health standards. Okay, so this is showing that. And in order to talk about an importance on society or showing how this topic is relevant, I'll just say a sentence like, if not properly taken care of, these problems could cause harmful long-term effects to future generations in terms of disease and a higher cost of living. So you see how I've sort of taken this last sentence and I've shown how it's an importance on society, but it also relates back to my first sentence. Okay, and this is my essay. So for me, these ideas came quickly, but I used this outline in order to make everything very clear. Got my topic sentences in bold, my explanations in italics, my example in normal print. And you see how each paragraph has this very clearly. The introduction and the conclusion are a bit different, but they satisfy my outline, and it's all very clear. In terms of the grammar, remember here I've got present perfect, here I've got some future, I have present perfect again, and I've got a lot of great phrasal verbs. So for example, taken care of, I have prone to something here, this is a great phrase, passing something on. I also have modals, so I have could because I'm speculating, and overall it's quite a well-rounded essay. So just to look at word count, we see here this is 31 words, which is pretty standard for an introduction. The first paragraph is 92 words. The third full paragraph is 90 words. And our conclusion is 46 words. And so total, that puts us at 259 words, which is perfect because we want to write at least 250 words. So the fact that we're right around there is perfect. You don't want to go too much over 300 because that would mean that you're either writing too much or you're not spending enough time on your first writing task, because remember, you've got about 40 minutes for this task and 20 minutes for your first writing task, so you'll need to allot your time well. But you want to stay at least 250 words and around there up to 300. Of course, this depends also on how familiar you are with the topic, but use this as a guideline. Now let's just wrap up. We'll look at some very handy do's and don'ts, and we'll just digest everything we've done in this lesson. Okay, now to wrap up, I just want to go over the main points of this lesson. First, you'll want to read and understand the question. So you're using your keywords, you're understanding which type of essay you have to write, and then you want to plan your outline, very important, and you want to make your outline notes. Now, for the cause and effect question type, we had two causes and two effects. This is great. This is the body of your outline, and it gives you a lot to write about and a lot of ways to show the examiner that you are really skilled in writing an essay. So two causes and two effects is generally a great way to go. Then make sure you use varied grammar structures and vocabulary. So think of your phrasal verbs, think of your collocations, and just great ways to show your knowledge and perhaps your advanced skill set in vocabulary. And of course, remember, there is a 250 word minimum, so you want to have at least 250 words, and you have 40 minutes for all of this. Remember, don't be scared with more practice. Reading and understanding, planning your outline, and making your notes will take hardly any time at all, and it will really pay off in the long run because you'll be able to write more quickly since you know what you're talking about and you have a clear plan. All right, thanks a lot. Great job. And if you'd like to practice more, please feel free to visit us at www.bestmytest.com/IELTS. Thanks, and I'll see you for the next lesson.